so many people facing eviction at this particular time. Tell us your name.
Christy Hall.
Christy, why are you facing eviction?
I was engaged. Fiance told me he was paying the rent. He wasn't. He up and left. Then I lost my job due to the COVID. And then I had to bury my mother a month and a half later.
So it's been one thing after another after another. Mm-hmm. How do you keep going in the middle of all this?
I pray.
How does prayer help you?
It calms me.
Is it?
And it helps me not to think the bad thoughts.
Right, because you're able to tell yourself, I don't want to go there. Mm-hmm. I'm going to put my mind on the things that are above. I'm going to do what Isaiah 26:3 says. I will keep him or her in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed upon thee, because they trust in thee, O Lord.
That's true.
And that's what keeps you going.
Yes.
How did you end up coming to New Life Evangelistic Center?
My mother used to volunteer for your prayer line some years ago. Oh, and right. I felt she was talking to me.
What was her name?
Margo Hall.
God bless you. And we're going to try to help you. Now, do you have children?
I have three. I have one that lives with me. She's a special needs adult.
Well, we're going to try to help you some with this, okay?
Okay.
But I need you to pray for us because we don't receive any city, state, or federal dollars, okay?
Okay.
I want to help you to do this and continue. You keep praying, and this will help you during this time. And then we're just to praise God when you get that stimulus assistance on that new law that's just been passed. You can apply that.
Yeah.
So you tell the landlord to hold off. You're doing what you can,
yeah,
okay?
I do.
Mm-hmm.
And I will.
But you said prayer gives you peace.
Yeah, it does.
Do you get a chance to get in the Bible and really read it?
Not like I used to.
Oh, we need to.
I need to.
I immerse myself in the Word of God every day.
Yeah.
Every day.
I do read Psalms 91 every day, though.
Okay.
I do that.
I encourage you to read through the Psalms from,
yeah.
Right on through them. Get into the Gospel of John. And just let the Holy Spirit just begin to open up the Word to you.
Okay.
And then get planted deep in your soul. I was quoting also Philippians 4, be anxious for nothing, but in everything with prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be known to God. And then it says, and the peace of God that passes all understanding shall be yours in Christ Jesus. There it is, right there.
Philippians 4.
Romans 8, there's so much in there.
It is.
And faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God.
Yes, it does. It does. And it rings in my mind all the time because of my mother.
Amen.
My mother.
We thank God for what he's doing at this hour, doesn't he?
Yes, I do.
Tell me about your prayer life. Is it praying without ceasing? Is there certain times you pray?
All day, I'm constantly doing that, constantly, just to keep my mind at a positive level.
What you're doing, I also want you to think about spelling out the word acts as you pray.
Okay.
You start out with the adoration. You just think about what a marvelous God you're serving. What a great God you're serving. From adoration, we move to confession. Lord, help me, Lord. And then we talk to God about that.
Okay.
The T then, and the word acts, is thanksgiving. We begin to thank him for all he's doing. And the S then is supplication, which means asking. So our heart and mind is prepared for the ask.
Yes.
And God is a miracle working God. Will you continue to keep seeking God? We're going to try to help you. I want to need all of you all praying with us. She's one of many that are coming to us. Let's go to Mark.
I'm joined here with Lucretia. And Lucretia, you came for rental assistance. What's going on?
I'm just a little bit behind in my rent. I moved and I had a little extra bills out there. So I fell short this month. And I just come for a little assistance. It's just a one-time thing. It's not ongoing. And I have turned my life around. I have three kids. I'm doing fine, blessed by the grace of God. And I want to thank Larry Rice for giving me the donation.
Okay. So how did you hear about us?
By telephone. I always kept your number from when he was downtown years ago. I always kept the number. I remember I've been a part of your program for years. I used the clothing room, the food pantry, a couple of classes for the bus tickets. I use the system wisely.
Now, you mentioned downtown, so that means you're familiar with Larry Rice being downtown.
Yes.
How has has his building being closed by the city affected you?
Oh, my God. I missed that so much. I mean, it was just like freedom. You can shop all over again for free, you know, get everything that you need. I remember one year I was pregnant with my 11-year-old, and I had my 14-year-old, and he was like 3. This is how long it's been. He's 14 now, and he was when he was 3. And I got him all the outfits he needed for the week for his new daycare. And it was great because I went down there and got some fundamental things, you know. And all my life I've been in St. Louis, I've always utilized the clothing room down there. I mean, from purses to shoes to anything, toys for your kids, you know, pillows, bedding. It just was a sacrifice that I made. But it was beneficial because anytime I needed to utilize the program, it was there for me to utilize. And like I said, they had sandwiches sometimes. You know, we took a Saturday walk downtown. You know, they were available for that. They had all type of giveaways and just, I mean, for the public, you know.
So it was beneficial to you?
Yes, it was.
Okay. So we're going to help you today. I understand that you moved to a newer place.
Yes, a bigger
right?
place.
A bigger place, and that you're just a little short on it.
Yes, just a little short on it.
Okay, we're going to help you today, and we thank you for your dedication and devotion to not only our Lord and Savior, but also the new life.
Yes.
Right? We're praying that we can get that building back open again.
Oh, you are?
We are praying for it, right? As a day center, at least. For the homeless, because the homeless have no place to go during the day.
Yes.
Right? So we're asking that God reopen it and we support it as a day center. So we want you to keep that in your prayers, too.
I sure will. I will pray for you guys and I will keep that in my prayers and I will continuously pray on it and hopefully that dream will come true.
Yes. We're asking God to move in a mighty, mighty way as He's done in your life repeatedly.
Yes, as He's done in my life repeatedly.
Okay. Lucretia, we want to thank you for being here today.
Thank you.
The COVID is in the air. It's something that we have to live with, and it's also fearful, and it's also real. Trust me, it is definitely real. And it has affected you, Marlo, in what way?
It affected me because the job, so many people were coming up with COVID at work with symptoms, and I didn't want to be around it. And I took the initiative to take off or try to distance myself, but ultimately lost my job back in January because I didn't want to be around the COVID
situation. So you lost your job because of the COVID?
I lost my job because of the COVID, and I fell behind. Daughter's tuition was due. Lecture bill was due, so I made the executive decision to pay the tuition and not the lecture bill. Now that I regained employment, it's one of them trying to get
so
back on track.
So you're back employed now?
Yes, I'm back employed.
All right, so you didn't give up?
No, I didn't.
Right, you didn't let the COVID beat you?
Oh, no.
Right?
No,
I can't. You kept moving ahead.
I have to keep moving ahead. It's just like the tracks in the sand. It's one of them. I don't see the second set of tracks, but I know they're there, so I just keep
moving. So what happened with Ameren?
Well, with Ameren, it was my daughter's tuition was due for her to go back to school, and Ameren was due. I was under a payment agreement. I couldn't fulfill the payment agreement in full. And so with Ameren, they was like, hey, you got to give us our money or your life's going to be off money.
So with a payment agreement, if you do not fulfill the payment agreement, the whole amount becomes due, correct?
The whole amount becomes due immediately.
Not only are people having a hard time with the rent in the midst of COVID, but also the utilities.
Yes.
Tell us your name.
My name is Sharon Wilkerson.
Sharon, what kind of problems are you having with utilities?
Well, I'm having problems paying my utility bills. I've been off work with injury.
What kind of job did you do?
I worked at a pharmaceutical plant, and I was a shipper. I shipped boxes out of the plant, and which I hurt my rotator cuff. I had surgery November 13th, and they had to terminate me because I've exhausted all of my sick leave after 5 years of service, all of my sick leave, PTO, vacation. And I was getting my short-term disability. At this point, I'm waiting to hear about long-term disability. And it was a job I really loved and enjoyed going to. So heart was kind of broken to know that you would terminate me. You know, when I'm fighting, trying to get back, going through all my physical therapy. So at the point of them terminating me, I've lost my medical insurance, in which I'm in the middle of physical therapy. I can't pay for it. It just seemed like a little vicious circle. But
how do you keep going in the middle of it all?
By the grace of God, the physical therapy place called me and said, you know, we have a program. And so now I just pay $25 a week. to go to my therapy. So just by God's blessings.
How does he make a difference in your life?
Well, he makes a difference because he's there for me. He make things happen. You just don't know when or where or how. I didn't even get stressed about not being able to go to the doctor or go to physical therapy, but he made a way. For instance, my doctors, now I have Christian Northeast, where they're paying 90% of my bills. I only have to pay 10%.
God is a miracle working God.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, right. So now I can continue with my medical health and try to regain my strength to go back to work, which they did give me an invitation to return to work when I'm well. It's just you kind of left out in the cold after giving your service for 5 years when they have to terminate you because you've exhausted all your benefits.
Amen. So. Yeah. I thank God for those of you that make it possible for us to be there when the people are hurting through your faithful support. So many are in need. How did you end up coming here?
My daughter told me about it.
Did she?
Mm-hmm.
Well, God is a miracle working God, and we praise him for all of you that are praying for us here at the New Life Evangelistic Center now, all of you that are sharing with us. So many people keep coming here all the time, and phones ring, people in need, and yet day by day, we see how God miraculously provides. And as we see it as a community as a whole, you see it in your individual life.
Yes, you do.
Now, as a believer, we've got to really start praying for our cities. I mean, there's so much sin out there. There's so much stealing and violence and hatred and bitterness for our country. We need to really be praying right now for revival, don't we?
Yes, we do. We need to pray every day.
Oh, yes. A lot of people, it's easy just to give up. Things are so bad. They lament. They fear. They say it's going from bad to worse. And we see it, but we got to believe God for change, don't we?
Yes, we do. And we got to keep praying no matter what. Can't give up. Cannot give up.
Ask and it shall be given you. Seek and you'll find. Knock and it shall be opened unto you. 2 Chronicles 7:14 says, if my people who are called by my name will turn from their wicked ways, I will hear from heaven and heal their land. So that's what we need to do. He didn't say all those other people. He said, if my people, so if you consider yourself one of God's people, he said, my people who are called by my name, you know, that we need to call out on him right now. We need to pray right now.
Yes, we do. I have a prayer band on Facebook where we all just get together and pray and share prayers.
Well, pray for a revival to sweep through this.
Yes.
I've shared this before. Now, New Life Evangelistic Center actually sprung forth from the revival that took place in the late 60s, early 70s.
Mm-hmm.
President Kennedy had been killed. Vietnam War was at a peak. Mm-hmm. We saw, in addition to that, Dr. Martin Luther King killed.
Right.
Robert Kennedy. Young people just saw the system. It was not getting anywhere for them. They're down on politics, everything. A lot of them turned to drugs. In the middle of it all, the Holy Spirit began to move. And there was a hungering for the Word of God, and we couldn't get enough of the go to Bible studies and just to praise God and worship God. And God brought about great change at that moment, and we need another revival right now.
We do.
A mighty revival.
Well, we do.
People carrying guns and people shooting each other and all this stuff going on.
The pandemic going on.
Oh,
and that keeps a lot of the people out of church. And that's when a lot of my church family start going to Facebook and just praying together and sharing the word amongst each other.
And they can keep doing that even when they go back to church.
Yes, yes.
Yes. You want COVID to end, you
it
see one variant.
Gives you strength and encouragement.
And they keep thinking, oh, we got it solved. Here's a vaccine. But then a new variant comes up. Then another one comes up. So we got to get down before God. And if this COVID thing doesn't wake people up, what's it going to take? Brothers and sisters, we need to really get gone before God. I remember after this great earthquake hit Mexico City and thousands of people died. We sent tractor loads of stuff there. And I went down there with one of the young men on our training program who's Hispanic.
Mm-hmm.
And I was with all these family members outside the hospital where they were issuing who died. And the Lord had me share a message. And one of the things he had me share is God keeps trying to get his people to come to him. He keeps talking to them. But if they don't listen to him, first it'd be a still, small voice, and the voice would get louder and louder till the very earth rumbles.
And well, the people just hung on to the Word of God. I preached 3 or 4 sermons. Finally got exhausted, had to run to the taxi, and they kept chasing me for more. God, do we have to have an earthquake? What do we have to have? This COVID should wake us up. We got to get back to God now, don't we?
Yes, we do. Yes. Everybody needs to get back to God.
Let's get back to the Lord.
Yes.
Amen. Well, He gives us opportunities to minister to a lot of people here at the New Life Evangelistic Center. You all be praying for us as we continue to reach out through the love of Jesus in word and deed. Praise God for all you wonderful partners. Let's go to Brother Mark.
Trust me, the COVID-19 is real. I am a survivor of the COVID-19. I had symptoms. I got sick. I went to SLU, and they brought me back to health. But what actually brought me back to health was the prayers of the devoted and dedicated. I'm here with Darion, and you also had the symptoms of COVID.
Yes, I did.
Tell me about it.
I had the symptoms. I was feeling lightheaded. Sometimes I say you don't really know if you got it until. So I just wasn't feeling good. So I had went to the hospital and stuff like that. And this is actually before I had to be at work. And, they tested me and stuff like that. And they said you might have the symptom. You might have it. And my results haven't came back at that time. And
so I'm going to stop for a moment. When you had the symptoms and they said you might have it, right?
Mm-hmm.
What thoughts went through your mind?
I just didn't know what to do because I never been like that sick before or had anything like that ever. So
did you think there was a death sentence for you?
I don't think it was a death sentence. I just felt like...
But people were dying from it.
They were. And God showed me a little favor, and I was thankful.
Now, you mentioned God.
Yes. Okay. He is good, because without Him, I wouldn't, got well enough to take care of myself, because I could have been one of those other people and not made it.
Right. You could have been one of the 500,000 plus that died from this disease.
Correct.
So you mentioned God. How did God play a role in your life in the COVID?
He kept me. He protected me through everything, because like I said before, I could have been one of those 500,000 people,
right.
So didn't make
forward.
It.
Let's fast forward.
Mm-hmm.
You got tested. And what did the test show?
It showed that I was negative.
Okay, praise the Lord. Praise God.
Yes, right. I was negative.
But it still affected you. The COVID still affected you because
it did.
You had to quarantine?
I had to quarantine for 14 days. I had to prove documents to my employment that, I had the symptoms, and they told me to isolate. But in the process, I still lost my job, and I went through a lot of stuff, bills and a lot of other things, all because of this.
Now, are you working now?
Yes, I am working now, officially. Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Yes, I'm thankful that I'm working now, and I'm just trying to get back on track like how I was before I lost my job, and, before all this stuff happened, it kind of like...
You're trying to return back to what you were before.
Correct. Right. I'm trying to get back on track to where I left off at, basically.
But Darion, I admire you because you have not allowed this COVID disease, a disease, I think, from the very pits of hell... to destroy your life.
Yes, I'm grateful.
Right?
Yes.
Okay, so how has your faith played a role in this?
It played a big role because, I really didn't have anybody else to lean and depend on, but God, He was the only person that I can really count on and depend on. And, ask for help at that moment, because when people, family, friends let you down or turn their back, He's always there.
Okay. And it's the same with me. Right, through the darkness, through the pain, through the loneliness, through the hopelessness, God was there, and God saved me, as He saved Darion. I'm going to ask you to keep Darion in prayer. We're going to help you with your electric bill today. Okay, we want to thank you for giving us an opportunity to show the love of Jesus Christ to you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
So many people with so many needs. And it's so important we come into the presence of God in the middle of all this need. Do you do that?
Yes, sir.
Tell us your name.
Monica Robinson.
You'll have to speak up a little bit.
Monica Robinson.
All right, very good. And do you have children?
Yes, sir, I have 2.
How old are they?
9 and 7.
9 and 7. Now, what kind of need are you facing right now?
Help with our utilities.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
What kind of utility bill?
Our Ameren and our Spire.
How much is that Ameren electric bill?
Our electric bill right now is $861.
Yeah?
Yeah, we have
And what about the gas bill, the Spire?
The gas was $437, I believe.
Okay. And they fixing to shut you off?
I have disconnection on both, yes, sir.
Wow. We need to just continue to look to God. We're going to try to help you with some today. You let them know you're trying, all right?
Yes, sir. I've been calling and keeping up, like they say when they send the letters, give us a call. So, trying to keep communication open.
How do you keep on going? And how do you encourage the children?
Well, honestly, when we get up in the morning, we say good morning to each other. Mm-hmm. Because I was taught that when you say good morning, that's already an awesome miracle. He woke you up.
Yes.
And we go through the first part of the day, and when we say good afternoon, that means he's working. And when we go to the evening, that means we're rounding up, and when we say good night, job well done. And we start over again. We do the things that we need to do first, that we can't do without, and we work on everything else afterwards.
What part does God play in your life?
The faith.
Faith. Explain it to me.
Knowing that he's there.
Knowing he's there.
Yeah, like the footprints prayer.
And let me ask you a question. You tell somebody that out there and they'd say, well, how do you know he's there?
How do I know he's there? Because I believe firmly. I was raised believing in him. And when times are hard and I drop my head and pray, he works for me. Mm-hmm. Might not be when I want him to, but it's always before anything go wrong.
He's there, isn't he?
Mm-hmm.
Also, when we stop and think about the resurrection, Jesus died on the cross. All the disciples ran off.
Mm-hmm.
If they could have produced a body, it had killed Christianity right at the moment. They could never produce the body because Christ rose from the dead.
Mm-hmm. He ascended.
Yes. He rose and he said, I'm with you always, even to the end of the world. He says, be anxious for nothing, the Bible tells us.
Yeah.
Trust him.
Lean not on your own understanding.
So like you said, things work out. It tells you in Romans 8:28 that all things, not just some things, work together for good to them who love God and are called according to his purpose.
Word, yes.
Do you
That's
read
my
the Bible?
Favorite book, Romans.
Do you read the Bible?
Yes, sir. It's been a little bit, but I do, and that's my favorite book, Romans.
It's a great book, particularly Romans chapter 8.
Yes.
No matter how high you go. Yeah, but he said no matter how high you go, no matter how low you go, no matter how far you go or wide, you can never get away from God's love.
No, you can't.
You can't. He's right there in the middle of it. He loves you.
Yes, he does. In my foot, when you walk in the front door of my house, I got a Bible open that was my grandmother's, and it has Matthew chapter 5 in there with the bow ties. And when you lead to my kitchen, it has Romans chapter open in my grandfather's Bible.
We're going to take time to read it, though.
Yeah.
We got to get the word down deep into our heart, our spirit, mm-hmm. to the extent like Abraham, we can be fully persuaded.
Yes.
Fully persuaded. How'd you end up coming to New Life Evangelistic?
Well, I heard of your program to help with assistance.
Mm-hmm.
So I called in and got an appointment to come in. Right. And you guys are always really nice, really informational. And y'all set us up on our way that we could continue to move on and move forward.
I thank God for all of you that make it possible. Oh, what a wonderful, wonderful God we serve. And just what tremendous opportunities he gives us to celebrate his power, his presence, his love. As we stop and think about how he died for us, how he rose from the dead, and how we have hope both now and for all eternity.
Yes.
I want you to think about that, brothers and sisters, because Christ is risen, and believing that changes everything. Oh, it's amazing. The resurrection power of Christ can break the chains, whatever the chains may be, whether it's fear, addictions, I mean, whatever. That's what happens. As many as call upon the name of the Lord shall be called the children of God. Yes, Jesus has come to set the captives free. So I encourage you at this moment to call on the name of the Lord. Just tell him right where you're at, Lord, I need you. I'm at my wit's end. I don't know which direction to go except to you. And as you call upon him, as you confess your sins, and just believe him for miracles, you're going to see him open up a door in your heart You're going to see the power of the Holy Spirit coming into your life. You're going to see as you step out by faith, knowing He's right beside you, how He does exceedingly beyond what you can even ask or think. That's what awaits us. So let's not continue to live in fear, worry, unbelief. Instead, let's come to our resurrected Lord. Let's experience His power now. And let's see Him do this mighty work that He has for each and every one of us. You may be going through some real trials and tribulations now, but let God use the time to take the word you got in your head, bring it into your heart, where you too can experience His peace that passes all understanding. Remember I mentioned to you Philippians 4? Go look at it. Be anxious for nothing, but everything with prayer and supplication. With thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God, and the peace of God is yours. Come and experience His peace right now.